Good evening, Sharyland community. My name is Nancy Barbosa, and I am the PR director for Sharyland ISD. Welcome to our third town hall meeting. This evening, we're going to be giving a general overview of the upcoming bonds slated for May 1. We have Dr. Vidaudi, who is going to be starting with the presentation, and we also have Mr. Doherty, who is going to be reviewing our facilities, and Mr. Ortega, who will be reviewing the finances. Thank you for joining us, and we're going to get started.
Wonderful, wonderful. Well, thank you, Ms. Barbosa, for that introduction, and thank you all for joining us here tonight. We do first want to share a little bit of information to show you what got us to the point we're at today, in which we called a bond election for May 1, 2021. So we'll start off with looking at what has happened in the past. Well, in the past, we've had a long-range facility committee that has been engaged for the last 2 years. This committee is made up of community members that were selected and nominated by our Board of Trustees. And so we've looked over and we've done a facilities comprehensive needs assessment. What is out on our campuses? What needs to be done? And as we all know, at some point, our aging facilities get to a point in which our own budget, the repairs that are needed, our own budget cannot sustain. That's where we are today with two campuses, which are our oldest campuses, John H. Shary Elementary and Sharyland High School. We also know that this is the most opportune time to do this because of some things that have happened in the legislature with House Bill 3, and Mr. Ortega will share a little bit more about that. I also want to take this time to really recognize the Board of Trustees over the last 10 years in which they've done these extensive comprehensive needs assessments and have been looking at our buildings as we go. So knowing that, we get to the point that we're at today in which we want to provide a safe and conducive environment for these two campuses that we're talking about right now. So if we look at where we're at, just to kind of recap, we've had the Long Range Facility Committee, we've met with them, we've done tours, we've talked about, as you may know, we did go out for this bond in November, and it did fail. And so we went back to the committee and said, okay, what are some things that we could do differently? What do we think happened? What do we think went wrong? We looked at that, we made some evaluations about that, we looked at it again, took them on tours, showed them, and then at that point decided, you know, as a leader, I had two choices to make. I either move forward and wait 3 to 5 years and try this again, or I move forward and take this back to the board saying, you know what, these needs are still here and we do need something, do need to take care of those at these two campuses. That's what we chose to do in February 2021. We took this back to the board and we did call a bond election for May 1st, 2021 for $35 million. So if we think about what the bond vision was, the first go around was for $40 million. What we thought maybe as a committee that was a little confusing for the voters was that there was two propositions. Proposition A was all the improvements needed at the two campuses I've talked about, and Proposition B was for a central admin building. As some of you may know or may not know, our central administration building has been condemned since 2016. Our hopes that could be able to move the building that I'm in right now and the finance department, that we could move into an admin building and then give that building back to Sharyland High School. So after discussion with our Board of Trustees, we went back. You can flip it. There you go. And the new bond vision is for $35 million. And of course, like I said, we went back to our long-range facility committee and came back with a $35 million bond vision, taking care of the two campuses that we talked about. Mr. Doherty will share a little bit about that. But before we go on, I do want to recognize that we do have two board members with us here today, Mr. Keith Padilla, our president, and we do have Mr. Alejandro Rodriguez with us. So thank you all for being here today. At this point, I'm going to turn it over to Mr. Doherty so he can talk to you about the improvements that we're expecting at each of the campuses should the bond pass.
Thank you, Dr. Vidaudi. So when we looked at the bond, as Dr. Vidaudi mentioned, we focused on our two oldest campuses. And the one that we're going to start off with is John H. Shary Elementary. What we did is we brought out our architect and our engineers, and we walked the facilities. So the numbers that we're going to present tonight are just budgetary numbers, but it gives us a good idea of the cost of what we're looking to get completed. So here at John H. Shary, when it was built back in 1992, it was built for pre-K through second grade. So right now we have sixth grade students that are sitting in classrooms that were made for students that were in second grade. So we've got, if you have any kids that are in that age group, you realize a second grader and a sixth grader, they grow. So one of the things that we want to look at is to add some additional classrooms for our sixth grade students, give them proper space that they need for their learning. Also in that, we're gonna in that wing, we talked about adding a library. The library here, in comparisons to the other ones that we have at our other elementaries, is completely different. We talked about doing some interior renovations to the classrooms. So when we build the new wing and we add the library, we want to take the existing library, especially after speaking with the administrative staff on campus, and we want to convert it into some offices and to some meeting areas for them. Another concern that we have here is during pickup and drop-off time in the morning. Glasscock Road, it's a major thoroughfare, but it's only a two-lane road, one lane going each way. So there's an adjacent piece of property right next to the campus that the district owns, and we want to take that property and we want to turn it into a parking lot. And then we want to use that parking lot for pickup and drop-off so we can stack and queue parents there. We feel it'll give us a safer pickup and drop-off for our students, staff, and our teachers. David, if you go to the next slide. So one of the renderings that we've spoken about is the additional wing. So if you can see, you've got on the left, you've got six classrooms. You've got a facility for teachers to teacher workroom. You also have some other facilities that the teachers can use. Then down at the bottom, you have the library. The library will consist, of course, of the library, three classrooms / computer labs, offices, storage area. This will put them in line with the other elementary campuses that we have in the district. The picture to the right is virtually the same, except down at the bottom, that's where we are at talking about adding the new parking for the new queuing and stacking here at John H. Shary Elementary. This is a rendering. We would tie it in the new wing to the back of the campus, and we would tie into the existing architect that we have. Picture to the left shows the current library with its computer lab. The picture to the right will be one idea, one rendering of what the new library could look like. So when the other part of the campaign, or the other part of the bond, excuse me, that we have now is at the high school. The high school was built, the main high school building was built in 1976. So in there, what we'd like to do is we'd like to do some interior renovations, definitely do some HVAC and code upgrades to the building. The building right now is grandfathered in, so we're okay, we're legal with where we're at, but we'd like to bring it now to standards of 2021 instead of 1976 when it was built. We also looking to add some new additional office space for the administration, and then add an innovation center with some more classrooms and work areas for teachers and students. Another project there at the high school that would be covered under the bond would be the science building. There in the science building, again, it's one of the older buildings that we have. We would like to bring the HVAC, and we would like to have code upgrades brought up to 2021 standards, as well as doing some interior renovations to the classrooms and the science labs in there. We're also looking at the band hall. The band hall is another of the older buildings that we have on campus. We would like to do some demolition of the interior work and do some new interior to the existing band hall to make it more convenient for students and the band directors, as well as add some additional band hall and choir space for them. And then we're also looking to do some renovations to our cafeteria. There in the cafeteria right now, if students go in, they get their food. If they're able to go on one side of the, on the west side of the cafeteria, and they can sit down. But if they want to get up and go to the east side of the cafeteria, they've got to walk outside in the elements with their food. So if it's cold and raining, well, they're outside in those elements with their food. So we want to redesign it to make it more conducive, a better flow for the students, to keep them indoor the whole time there. So we're going to look at some renderings that we have. The picture to the left is the current, what the current main building looks like. Picture to the right would be one of the renderings that we've looked at with the additional space, office space that was requested, as well as the Innovation Center. What you see here is just a rough schematic. The picture on the left shows what the hallways look like right now. On the right-hand side, the schematic drawing that you see, the area shaded in blue, that's where we would add the additional office space. The building that's to the right of it is the new Innovation Center that we are proposing. Again, another rendering, you get some more pictures of what the hallways look like. It shows the age of the building. One of the things that we would do as well, the area again shaded in blue over here, is the current existing office space that we have in the high school, and we would look to renovate that, demolish some walls, and make a better flow for staff and students there as well. We'd also look to do renovations through the hallways, classrooms. We also talked about HVAC and code upgrades. The picture on the left shows the hallway in the science building. The picture you see on the right shows what one of the renderings, one of the ideas of what the hallways could look like once this project is completed. The other building that we did talk about was a band hall. The picture on the left that you see is the current exterior entrance to the band hall. The picture on the right is a rendering drawing of what it would look like with what it could look like with the addition of the new choir hall up front. Right now, what you see here is the current band hall that we have, and on the right-hand side are the schematics for what the new band hall would look like. So the area shaded in gray is the current space that we have right now. That space would be reworked to make it more efficient, a better use of space for the band students and the band teachers, and the areas shaded in tan would be the additional band hall and choir hall. Here's another drawing, you see another picture of the band hall, and the one to the right, the picture to the right would be a rendering of what the new band hall could look like. The cafeteria. So the picture on the left side of the slide is what the current cafeteria looks like right now. The picture on the right shows what it could look like, one of the ideas and renderings that we have should the bond pass and we're able to do this work. So right now, this is a rough schematic drawing. One of the challenges that we have at the high school is you have not only Sherryland High School, but you have SA3 there. So you have approximately 2,000 students on campus, and our child nutrition department tries to feed them within two lunch periods. So we want to make sure that we can accommodate enough seating for the students so we can have seating for at least 1,000 students during each lunch period. We can accomplish that by enclosing the east side of the pavilion on the east side of the band hall. And so this would then have everything enclosed. Students could walk in through the central part, grab their food, and it would be set up in what our child nutrition department calls a scramble style system. Students would get their food, can sit anywhere in the cafeteria, but yet not have to go outdoors with their foods to get there. They can be seated, they can be indoors throughout the whole time during their lunch period. So right now, due to COVID, you'll see that the way we have the cafeteria set up for our high school students right now when they do have lunch, and that's set up right now because of the COVID precautions we're taking. But we're hoping that we can get through this pandemic. And so these are just some idea. This is just one idea, I should say, of what the new cafeteria seating could look like. And with that, I'll turn it over to Mr. Ortega.
Thank you, Mark. So what's the cost to the taxpayers? How is this bond going to impact the tax rate? I'd like to start off by just covering a little bit of the tax rate history. So in 2013-2014, the district's tax rate was at $1.2855. That year, in preparation to open up a new high school, a taxpayer saw a 5 cent increase to $1.3355. The tax rate remained the same for 2 years. During those 2 years, the district did identify some additional capital project needs. So taxpayers saw a 4 cent increase to $1.3755. Tax rate remained the same for 3 years. And as Dr. Vidaudi mentioned, the state passed House Bill 3. So basically what House Bill 3 called for was some tax relief to local taxpayers. So House Bill 3 mandated that the district compresses tax rate. So the district reduces tax rate by 7 cents to $1.2987. With House Bill 3 still being in place, the district saw another compression of almost 2 cents to the current tax rate of $1.2808. So as Dr. Vidaudi mentioned, a great opportunity for the district to go out for a $35 million bond, and with House Bill 3 still being in place and with the district being able to refinance some existing bonds and having some great savings and interest, the district is able to go out for a $35 million bond, and local taxpayers would not see a tax increase from the current rate right now. So looking at the graph, currently we're at $1.2808, and for the next 12 years, taxpayers would not see an increase above that rate. As a matter of fact, we would average about $1.2760 before the tax rate eventually dropping off as some existing bonds are paid off. So let's talk about the bond campaign. The role of the district is to educate, to talk about the process, share facts, encourage voter registration, encourage voter turnout, and to create on our website a bond tab. State law prevents the districts from using public funds or resources to advocate for or against a bond. The role of the community is to advocate, to promote the bond, share the facts, encourage voter registration, encourage voter turnout, and to distribute flyers. Parents and community members may advocate freely for a bond. So as I mentioned earlier, we do have on our website a bond link, and as Mr. Culberson navigates through it, we do have a lot more information on bond 2021, bond facts, who served on the planning committee meeting, frequently asked questions. There's over 37 questions that have already been asked. voting information, tax information, upcoming meetings, past bonds, and contact us link. You want to go through that, Dave? So as we bring up the contact us link, real easy to fill out. Just all we need is your name, your email address, and you can put your question or comment under. We do monitor this daily, so we would answer any questions or comments under. At this time, this concludes our presentation. I'll go ahead and turn it over to Dr. Vidaudi.
Great. Yes, thank you, Mr. Ortega. Thank you, Mr. Daugherty. And that is the information that we have to share with the public right now. We'll entertain any questions if anyone has any questions. Are there any online? No? Any questions here? No? So, Ms. Barbosa, how are we doing the tour? I will turn that back over to you then.
Thank you. For those of you that are joining us online, I know we have quite a few people that are joining us online. So we are going to do a school tour. So you see firsthand what those needs are and the vision of what the bond is. That is going to be headed by Mr. Daugherty and our principal of this campus, Mrs. Rebecca Gerglach. So if I could please have you go to the front and the rest of the audience will follow. And for those of you joining us online, enjoy the tour. And if you have any questions, please make sure to submit them, and we will address them accordingly after the meeting.
Thank you. talked about the additional parking, and then from there we're going to head to the back of the campus so you can see,
the area. Okay, so to start off, we're gonna go up front. We're gonna show you the land that we have that's right next to the campus that we talked about for the parking, for the additional cubing and stacking that we have. So we can come out. So this is the area, the plot of land. It's a large plot of land that we would turn portion of it into a parking lot, and in that parking lot we would have stacking, queuing, bring on parents. Instead of having parents wait on the road that sometimes wraps around all the way to Griffin Parkway, we can bring the parents and keep them in here and not affect traffic flow. Again, doing that, we feel we have much safer drop off and pick up for our students, teachers, and staff members.
In addition to that, this is usually our overflow parking area anytime we have campus events, and it's always been a safety concern of our parents here at John H. Shary, because when it does get a little, wet outside, it makes it quite difficult. So this would be a wonderful improvement.
Let's head to the back.
This would be the area where we're hoping to build our sixth grade wing. As you can see, we've been blessed with a nice piece of property, and so this would make the ideal location for an additional expansion.
And we know, we see, if you've been here, that beautiful trees. We'll make every possible accommodation to make sure that those trees get moved properly, and we don't just cut them down. They are beautiful. So now we're going to move inside, and we're going to show a sixth grade classroom. Thank you, sir.
Number of desks that would typically be in here. As you can see, there is not very much space to move around. Our students are usually pretty close together, and it's a bit difficult to do some different instructional arrangements here as well. So we're a little bit limited. Also, if you can tell by the size of the area over here, as we were mentioning earlier, this was intended to be a pre-K through second grade campus. And so the wash areas are still in all of the classrooms, quite small for sixth graders who a lot of times are as tall as I am.
And this classroom is set up what would typically be a normal sixth grade. It's not set up right now with our COVID processes that we have in place. But we wanted to show everybody what a typical classroom would look like.
We'll go ahead and move into our kinder classrooms. Areas. We only have two in the campus, and we have a large staff, and so sometimes it takes a while just to wait your turn, and so this would definitely be a very much appreciated upgrade.
So in the new additional wing, we would add more staff bathrooms for them.
So finally, this is our library facility. We take great pride in reading here at John H. Shary, and our students and our families love to come in and read. We host a lot of family reading nights here as well. And so as you can see, the size of the library is very small. We do have some computers over there where students test in comparison to the other elementaries, where the areas are much larger. I think that a larger area would be very beneficial.
The other elementaries have three separate rooms for computer labs that can be computer labs and classrooms. Here we have just one area off to the side of that. So the new library in the new wing is gonna be comparable to what we have at all the other elementary campuses.
All right, so this concludes our tour.
So if, again, as was mentioned earlier, if there's any questions that y'all may have, please log into the Bond tab on the district page and submit your questions, and we'll be more than happy to answer them.
Absolutely. Thank you all for joining us today. And it was a quick little tour, but please, if you need any information, any questions you have, please feel free to reach out to us either through the webpage or just email us. Thank you all.
Cool.